Hello everyone, welcome to the ITLS Academy. Our today's lecture is based on the topic milk and its composition. Okay, let's start with first see the definition. Milk may be defined as the whole fresh clean lacteal secretion obtained by the complete milking of one or more healthy milky animal. In India, the term milk when unqualified refers to cow or buffalo milk or the combination of the two. The term market milk refers to the fluid whole milk that is sold to individuals, usually for direct consumption. It excludes milk consumed on the farm and that used for the manufacture of dairy products. Okay, here are the certain compositions that we get in milk from different species. We get milk from different species and they possess different compositions. For example, the camel, which constitute camel's milk constitute of 86 to 88% of water, 3 to 3.9% of protein, 2.9 to 5.4% of fat, in which ash is 0.6 to 0.9%, and lactose amount is 3.3%. Let's talk about the cow's milk. Cow's milk generally consists of 85 to 87% of water, 3.2 to 3.8% of protein, 3.7 to 4.4% of fat, and ash content is 0.7 to 0.8%, and lactose is 4.8 to 4.9%. In buffalo's milk, it consists of generally 82 to 84% of water, 3.3 to 3.6% of protein, 7.0 to 11.5% of fat, 0.8 to 0.9% is the ash content, and 4.5 to 5.0% of the lactose present in the buffalo's milk. Talking about the sheep milk, it consists of 79 to 82% of water, 5.6 to 6.7% of protein, 6.9 to 8.6% of fat, 0.9 to 0.1% of the ash, and the 4.3 to 4.8% is to lactase percent in the sheep milk. Talking about the goat milk, goat milk consists of 87 to 88% of water content in it, 2.9 to 3.7% of protein, 4.4 to 4.5% of fat, 0.8 to 0.9% of the ash content, and 3.6 to 4.2% of the lactose present in goat milk. In human milk, generally consists of 88 to 89% of the water content, 1.1 to 1.3% of the protein, 3.3 to 4.7% of the fat, 0.2 to 0.3% of the ash, and lactose is 6.8 to 7% in is the lactose content in the human milk. Okay, here are the compositions of milk that we have discussed earlier, that it is consist of fat, water, fat, protein. Now let's talk about the water. Water constitutes the medium in which the other milk constituents are either dissolved or suspended. Most of it is free and only a very few, only a very small portion is in the bound form, being firmly bounded by milk proteins or phospholipids, etc. The next one is the milk fat. The bulk of the fat in the milk exists in the form of small globules, which averages approximately 2 to 5 microns in size. This is an oil in water type emulsion. The surface of these fat globules is coated with an adsorbed layer of material, commonly known as fat globule membrane, that contains phospholipids and proteins. This membrane prevents the fat globules from coalescing and separating from one another. The milk fat is composed of a number glyceride esters of fatty acids. Milk fat on hydrolysis gives a mixture of fatty acids and glycerol. The fat associated substances are phospholipid, cholesterol, carotene, fat soluble vitamins such as A, D, E, K. Okay, here are the compositions of milk. The water is generally in average is found at 87%. Protein is of general found in is as 3.5% casein and whey form. The fat is present in an amount of 3.5 to 3.7%. Carbohydrate present is 4.9%. Vitamins, certain vitamins also present in the milk, that is the niacin, riboflavin, thiamine, vitamin B6, vitamin A, D, depending on the fortification. Certain minerals are also found in milk, such as calcium, potassium, magnesium, phosphorus, sodium, etc. Certain enzymes are also found in this, lipases, proteases, peroxidases. These are the certain other, these are the main compositions, such as phospholipids. Let's talk about the phospholipids. Three types of phospholipids, that is lecithin, cephaline, and sphingomyelin. The lecithin, which forms an important constituent of the fat globule membrane, contributes to the richness of flavor of milk and the other dairy product. It is highly sensitive to oxidative changes, giving rise to oxidized metallic flavor. Phospholipids are excellent emulsifying agent and no doubt serve to stabilize the milk fat emulsion. Let's talk about the cholesterol. This appears to be present in true solution in a fat as a part of fat globule membrane complex and in complex formation with protein in the non-fat portion of the milk. The next one is the fat soluble pigment. Carotene in fat soluble and responsible for yellow color of milk, cream, butter, ghee, and other fat-rich products. Carotene acts as an antioxidant and also as a precursor of vitamin A. One molecule of B carotene gives two molecules of vitamin A, whereas alpha carotene gives one molecule. The next one is the fat-soluble vitamins. Milk is rich in fat-soluble vitamins, for example, A, D, E, and K. The next one is the milk sugar or lactose. This milk sugar or lactose, this exists in milk only. It is in true solution in the milk serum. On crystallization from water, it forms hard, gritty crystals. It is 1/6 as sweet as sucrose. Lactose is responsible for the defect known as sandiness in ice cream and condensed milk. It is fermented by bacteria to yield lactic acid and other organic acid and is important both in production of cultured milk product and in the spoilage of milk and milk product by souring it. The next topic is the milk protein. The protein in milk consists mainly of casein, lactoglobulin, lactoalbumin, milk serum albumin and immunoglobulins, etc. Caseins form more than 80% of the total protein of the milk. Casein exists only in milk and is found in the form of calcium caseinate phosphate complex. It is present in colloidal state. The next one is the non-protein nitrogenous compound. For example, certain nitrogenous compounds are also present in this. Example, ammonia, amino acid, proteases, peptone, urea, uric acid, etc. The next is the mineral matter or ash. The mineral matter or salt of milk, although present in small quantities, exert considerable influence on the physicochemical properties and nutritive value of milk. The major salt constituent, that is those present in the appreciable quantities, include potassium, sodium, magnesium, calcium, phosphate, citrate, chloride, sulfate, and bicarbonate. Okay, here are certain other constituents also that is present in milk. Let's talk about them. First one is the pigments. Water-soluble pigments are riboflavin and xanthophyll. Riboflavin, besides being a vitamin, is a greenish-yellow pigment which gives characteristic color to whey. Earlier, it is known as lactoflavin or lactochrome. The next is the dissolved gases. Milk contains certain gases that is dissolved in it, for example, oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, etc. certain vitamins, that is water soluble vitamins B complex and vitamin C is also found in it. Certain enzymes, these are the biological catalyst. Milk contains amylase, lipase, phosphatase, proteases, peroxidases and catalase enzymes. These are the enzymes which are also present other than other factors. Okay, next topic is the factors affecting composition of milk. Milk differs widely in composition. All milk contains the same kind of constituent but in varying amount. Milk fat shows greatest daily variation and then come proteins followed by ash and lactose. The various factors that affect the composition of milk are, first one is the species. Each species yield milk of characteristics composition. This species that we have discussed in the second slide earlier, that different type of species have different compositions in the milk. The next one is the breed. In general, breed producing the largest amount of milk yield milk of a lower fat percent, vice versa. Holstein Friesian gives less fat whereas Jersey gives high fat in cow breeds. The individual variation. Third one is the individual variation. Each cow tends to yield milk of a composition that is characteristics of the individual. The next is the age. Fat percent increases up to third lactation and afterward it decreases. Next one is the milking interval. When milking is done a longer interval, the yield is more with a corresponding decrease in fat and vice versa. The next one is the completeness of milking. Fore milking contains less fat and strippings contains high fat. If the milking is not complete, it tests less fat. Irregularity in milking, frequent changes in the milking time and frequent changes in milking interval results in less fat. The next is the yield. With increase in yield per milking, the percentage of lactose increases while fat and non-fatty solid decreases. The next is the lactation effect. The first secretion after pasteurization, namely colostrum, high in globules and chlorides and low lactose content. The yield increases and attains maximum with 2 to 4 weeks and then slowly decreases. The next factor affecting is the hormones. Prolactin and thyroid hormone, which are essential for milk synthesis, increases the fat percentage. And the estrogen has a stimulating and depression effect. Optimum level causes increase in fat and higher doses decreases the fat percent. Next is the food and nutritive value of milk. Okay, milk is an almost ideal food. It has high nutritive value. It supplies body building proteins, bone forming minerals and health giving vitamins and furnishes energy giving lactose and milk fat. Besides supplying certain essentially fatty acids, it contains the above it contains all the nutrients in an easily digestible and assimilable form. All these properties make milk an important food for a pregnant mother, growing children, adolescent adults, invalid convalescents and patients alike. For example, let's talk about the first protein. Milk protein are complete protein of high quality, that is they contain all the essential amino acids in fairly large quantities. The next is the fat. Milk fat play a significant role in nutritive value, flavor and physical properties of milk and milk product. Besides serving as a source of energy, fat contains significant amounts of so-called essential fatty acids, that is the linoleic and arachidonic acids. The most distinctive role which milk fat plays in dairy product concerns about the flavor. The rich, pleasing flavor of milk lipid is not duplicated by any other type of fat. Milk fat imparts a soft body, smooth texture and rich taste to dairy products. Lastly, milk liquid undoubtedly enhance the consumer acceptability of the food. They also serves the best interest of human nutrition through the incentives of eating what tastes good. The next is the lactose. The principal function of lactose is to supply energy. However, so lactose also helps to establish a mildly acidic condition in the intestine, which checks the growth of proteolactic bacteria and facilitates the assimilation. The next is the minerals. Practically all the minerals and mineral elements found in milk are essential for nutrition. Milk is an excellent source of calcium and phosphorus, both of which together with vitamin D are essential for bone formation. Milk is rather low in iron, copper and iodine. The next one is the vitamins. These are necessary food factors which are essential for normal growth, health and reproduction of living organisms. Milk is a good source of vitamin A that provided the cow is fed with green feed and fodder. The vitamin D provided the cow is exposed to enough sunlight, thiamine, riboflavin, etc. Okay, the next is the energy value. The energy given milk constituents and their individual contributions are as follows. Milk fat is generally 9.3 calories per gram. Milk protein is 4.1 calories per gram. Milk sugar is 4.1 calorie per gram. The energy value of milk varies with its composition. On average of cow milk furnishes 75 calories per 100 gram. And buffalo's milk is 100 calories per 100 gram of milk. Thank you for being with us. For more information, please log on to our website www.itlsacademy.com.